And 1, 2, 3, whoop! Hello, Internet. So, the Theater Commandments community is nothing if not entertaining. And every once in a while on the blog, we have just, like, these waves of things. Like, one person will send in a message, and that will spark, like, a million other messages, and then it just keeps going on for, like, a few days, or a week, or forever. Like, you know, in the case of Put Amy in the Plant. And probably the biggest example of this phenomenon is when people send me M-word stories. Because really, once one person sends me one, that means that I am going to have, like, a never-ending supply of them in my inbox for the next week. And we also once had that thing where we all just kind of found out 100 different ways to get murdered inside a theater. And then we have the thing that I would like to discuss today, which is about glitter. Glitter, also known as theatrical herpes. Once you get glitter on something, you will never get it off. I know this to be a fact because I am eternally pulling glitter out of my hair. So anyway, somebody on Theater Commandments asked me, do you guys know anything that works well to get glitter off of a stage? We just wrapped up A Midsummer Night's Dream and the costuming department went wild and the stage managers and cleanup crew are about to lose it. And I said, no, because most of the stages I performed on throughout my life have like a permanent haze of glitter on the floor. I also suggested maybe using an armada of Swiffers. But the responses that followed that from followers of Theater Commandments were just priceless and absolutely hilarious. We had plenty of people send in their suggestions for glitter removal, including using a magic eraser, human tears, a buttload of black paint, a shop vac named Mike Dyson, raising the entire deck with a plasma torch. Someone suggested using peanut butter to get it off of your body, and let me just say right now, I will sooner walk out onto the streets of New York City looking like Edward Cullen before I take a shower and wash my body with peanut butter, okay? And somebody also said that burning the theater to the ground works about 80% of the time. But what was even better than people's suggestions for how to remove the glitter was people just straight up venting their frustrations and voicing their hatred for glitter. My personal favorite was one person that said, I will throw myself into the actual sun if my costume people ever do this to me. There was another response from Costumer Support Department, whom I absolutely love her blog. I think she's totally cool and y'all should go follow her, and she's probably never gonna see this video, but in case you do, hi, I think you're cool. But anyway, she said, my personal favorite reaction is suck it up and deal, our entire fucking shop's covered in the shit. Because when you're sewing, cutting, moving glitter fabric around, there's literally no way to contain it. None. And we hate it just as much, if not more. There was also another costume person who added, that moment where glitter has contaminated your fabric stash and the fabric must be humanely destroyed, aka put in a box to be used at a later date, you tell yourself, not believing a word. And then there was another beautiful response that was something along the lines of, glitter is Satan's own dandruff. And the thing is, I love glitter, but I also am aware of the consequences of glitter. Like, glitter looks great and sparkly while it's on and it's in its glory and its prime under stage lights. But glitter isn't that pretty anymore when you have to remove it. Because I cannot tell you how many times I have been standing in my bathroom at home or in a dressing room after a show, scrubbing my face and exfoliating like a mofo trying to get this stuff off. And it doesn't matter how hard I scrub my face. It does not matter what product I use to wipe my face down and wash my face. None of that matters. Because for the next month, I am going to have everybody that I see in real life be like, oh yeah, Amy, you have a sparkle on your eye. You have a sparkle on your face. Like, guys, I know. I do theater. I'm a performer. Like, I know. Like, when I was a kid and I was doing dance recitals, every year we would have to spray our hair with glitter hairspray or use glitter gel. But I remember even back then that when I would go to take a shower, I would be in there for a good long time scraping off the glitter that was on my body that had fallen off of my costume and trying my hardest to shampoo all the glitter out of my hair. But in reality, it would take about 10 showers to get the full, like, to get all of it out. I probably could yell about glitter for another hour, but I'm not going to because I do not have time for that. We now have shirts in the Theater Commandments store with different glitter removal strategies on them, which you should totally buy, by the way, because it helps me to keep the blog running and it helps me to pay for the website and stuff like that, and it'd be really cool. So, yeah, buy a shirt. But that's about the end of this video. Comment down below any of your funny glitter stories, any solutions you might have for glitter removal. Like this video if you thought it was cool or if you can relate to it. Subscribe to me if you have not already, and I will see y'all next Friday.